Namaste, beloved ones, and welcome. Welcome to this month's message of divine wisdom. And each and every time we have an opportunity to share this energy and this divine connection with you, we are humbled, we are grateful, and we are truly expanded together. So let's take a deep breath in. Let it out with sound. Do that again. And open your discernment lens. For your ascended heart is indeed the truth detector.
And so it is. Indeed, and so it is. Beloved angels of a great world that is in the formatic creation of the portals or the gateways of the divine process that many refer to as ascension. There are many that call out and ask for, as you would say, steps. They ask for, as you would say, procedures. They ask for protocols. We enjoy this word, protocol, because we have so much fun with it. Because it is pro, a professional, to call, a professional to call you out. And so, beloved ones, if we were to offer to you an ascension protocol, we would inspire thee, we would invite thee to recognize that you are being called. You are being called. Yet there is a difference between being called and being summoned. To be summoned means that there is no choice. To be summoned means that you are being demanded of. You are being partaken of. You are being, as they say in your world, commanded. And yet, to be summoned or commanded or demanded does not recognize the value, the blessing, and the journey of the gift of the form, the person beingness, meaning your soul in form, that journey in combination with free will. Free will is an energy that is born of this planet, used as a conceptual way to navigate decisions. Decisions are always present. Decisions are the gateway of free will. When you no longer are decisive, when you do not trust your own ability to decide, when you deny the inward knowledge that you are always, let us say that you are, because knowledge or wisdom is more accurate using the words of this realm. Wisdom is your truth. Wisdom is inherent. There are many ways that you may recognize your inner wisdom. And it is indeed part of the journey of density to challenge your wisdom. Whether or not you dive into those challenges is part of your journey. There may be times in your early experiences of form that you dive into the doubt of wisdom, that you defer wisdom or turn over wisdom, or Betty would use the word power, to others because of a lack of connection with the inner wisdom, which is synonymous with inner truth. And so you are being invited. You are being invited to dive deeply into the beauty of your wisdom, the authenticity of your wisdom, to trust the wisdom within. Now, for some of you, you may say, this is impossible for me to do. For every time I do this, I get myself into trouble, or things do not happen right, or I feel that I cannot trust myself. Okay, we wish to acknowledge this for the brain of density. Indeed, if you have been living in a state of denying your inner wisdom, if you have been living in a conditionary experience whereby you invite the opinion or the judgment, which is often thinly veiled opinion, of others to be able to make your own decisions, then indeed it is a time of great healing for thee. One of the ways to do this is to claim within thee the process of your self-ascension. By claiming the process of your self-ascension, by working forward through the steps of self-ascension, by allowing yourself to become the ever-refining spiral of self-ascension, you reawaken the inward trust, the inner knowing, and the deep connection to your wisdom. Deep connection to your wisdom does not demand words. Indeed, it often transcends words. Deep connection to your wisdom is recognizing that with each action, with each step, with each moment, you are trusting the guidance that is moving through you. You have invited the divine wisdom to be the illuminating presence within thee. And there is a soft smile, an inward recognition that all is being guided. This is important to recognize because it also implies the understanding of action. To be inactive is to say, I do not trust my flow. To simply wait is to say, I am stagnant. When we place into action our trusting love of the divinity of our truth as our movement in form, then the actions build upon the actions, and the serendipitous events become the miraculous connections. And the miraculous connections become the support structure of your ascension. Do you see, beloved ones, that in order to be called for a protocol, the professional calling, for the protocol of ascension is very simple. It is the divine flow of universal trust emanating through you, with you, as you, and allowing thyself to relax the nature of the human form that seeks to doubt the wisdom of the true form. When you open up yourself to the magnetic divinity of attraction, this is much more than the limited scope that many have spoken of. Many speak of the law of attraction for abundance in the form of financial or name, fame, glory. This indeed is the misperception brought forward through the Kali Yuga of the magnetization of attraction. The magnetization of attraction, which is a basic energy of the protocol of ascension, it is an energy that you are being called forward with each moment of each breath, of each day, of each hour, of each second, right now. It is the magnetic energy of attraction that says, I absolutely recognize, remember, trust, and flow with the divine pulse of the universe that is coming through me, with me, and as me. And as I allow this gift and remember it, it magnetizes, enlightens, and expands the cellular structure and the crystalline matrix of my own form, my energy, the world I am currently existing within in this linear time frame, and reaches and extends beyond a singular dimension. Through this, the true magnetic field of divine attraction expands. Imagine thyself right now. Simply feel thyself. You may wish to sit still if you are not already doing so, or lie still, and begin to feel yourself in divine flow. Imagine or feel the energy of divine, your divine nature, pulsing through you, with you, as you. You will feel a sense of floating, a sense of almost dematerialization, because the energy of the attraction, the trust of the universal flow, is what in truth holds your molecular structure in the form that you choose to create. For your form is constantly shifting, is it not? Even in the world of your science, there is great, as you would say, evidence or proof that the physical form is continually shifting. Your skin continually renews itself. Your cells continually replace themselves. Your bones, everything replaces, regenerates, renews. And so as you carry forth this divine trust, as you embody this divine energy, you remember that you are simply the beauteous form of magnetized, attracted energy that has attracted itself into a shape, that has attracted itself into a form, that has come together to support. When you ignite the truth within and release the doubt and invite the trust, when you invite the active force to sustain thee, it is then that the Ascension Protocol is already activated. For you cannot consciously call forward an activation. You can only invite the energy to reignite thee. You can invite thyself into harmonic balance. You can reacquaint yourself with the needed knowledge. Discover this knowledge in the way that your heart invites you to discover. Perhaps there is a word or an energy or a visible symbol. Perhaps it is simply gazing at one and you say, yes, I remember. Then invite yourself to receive the blessing of this communion, of this connection. Learn from the one who is offering the learning, and then allow thyself to learn ever more by connecting with the divine truth and the trust and the wisdom that is your divine nature. There is now, in your planetary structure, in this limited linear time field, a great pouring of energy. A great pouring of energy. This energy is carrying with it directional enhancements, north, south, east, west, northeast, southeast, southwest. All of these are igniting. And as they do, they carry with them subtle nuances that you are able to recognize, invite, and flow with. It is important to see that a compass will always show the directions, north, south, east, west. But while it shows the directions, it is possible for the directions themselves to shift. Yet the directions are not leaving, they are simply shifting. The compass still is true. It is simply the directions that are inviting you to become in union with them. For as you ignite your self-ascension, there is the step of being in union. Be in union, be in harmony, be in divine oneness with all. This is the form, the spirit, the earth, the elements, the air, the fire, the water, the ether. All must come together. For when you harmonize with all that has come together, the trusting soul within ignites and releases the doubts and fears of the form or the body that seeks to experience. And so now it is time to experience your Ascension Protocol. You are being called. You are already, as we say, the professional. For within you are all of the divine knowings, the wisdom teachings, and the understanding. And, beloved angels, recognize that the blessing of community, the blessing of harmonizing, without seeing age, without seeing gender, without seeing roles, it is simply the blending of sharing wisdom, is the gift that will illuminate many and bring forward ever more anchoring of the so-called protocol. This is a glorious moment. This is a glorious age. And this is a great opportunity to which your invitation has been gilded, engraved, delivered, and received. It is up to you now if you wish to attend. And so it is.
Love to you. Trust yourselves.